Hello, welcome to Comcast Newsmakers, bringing you news and information from people making a difference in our communities. I'm Beverly Weaver, and joining me now is Ruby Mayeda, Board Chair for the Colorado Women's Hall of Fame. Welcome, Ruby. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you for the opportunity.
Let's start, first of all, with explaining to our viewers what the Women's Hall of Fame is in Colorado.
Mm-hmm. Okay. The Hall of Fame was founded in 1985, and our mission is to inspire and celebrate the lifetime achievements of Colorado's extraordinary women.
And certainly it's been around for a long time, as you mentioned, one of the oldest Hall of Fames, I understand.
That's right. And something that makes us unique is that we are, I believe, the only Hall of Fame that is completely independent. We aren't supported by any government or university.
Let's talk about some of the examples of women that you have inducted in the Hall of Fame. Certainly a long list. 122 women have been inducted. Who are some of the most notable?
Madeleine Albright, we inducted in 2010, and she was the first woman Secretary of State, and at that time was also held the highest ranking position in the U.S. government. There's also Carlotta Lanier, who was one of the original Little Rock Nine. There's Marilyn Vandenberg Atler, that was one of our former Miss Americas and now is very dedicated to children's rights.
Right. Mm-hmm. And I know that last month you just released the list of the new inductees for the coming year. So tell me who you have on that list.
Right. We induct every 2 years up to 10 women, and the contemporary, because we work with both contemporary as well as historical women. And so of the contemporary women, there's Christy Anseth, who's a biomedical engineer, Temple Grand, a professor at CSU and animal sciences expert, and she's also an autism advocate.
Yes.
There's Ding Wen Su, who is a businesswoman and an Asian community leader. Huh. Loretta C. Ford, she is one of the co-founders of the nurse practitioner movement in this country. Yes. Marianne Kerwin, who is a women's health advocate. And Mary J. Malarkey, who is one of the first Colorado Supreme Court Chief Justices and the longest serving Chief Justices.
Certainly women who've made a name for themselves.
Yes, those are our contemporary women. And the historical ones is Janet Petra Bonema, who's a transportation engineer. She was one of the first women to be allowed into the Eisenhower Tunnel to work. Prior to that time, even though women qualified, they were given desk jobs. Fannie Mae Duncan, who is from the Colorado Springs area, she was instrumental in the peaceful integration in Colorado Springs through her cotton club. Aranea Garcia Gallegos, she was a postmaster that was appointed by President Roosevelt in the San Luis Valley. And lastly, Laura Gilpin, who is a nationally recognized photographer.
Right, so you bring some women in who are contemporary and, as you said, historical. How can people really get involved with the organization? I understand you're all volunteers, right?
Absolutely. We are 100% volunteer and a working board, so we can use people that are interested in our mission, either to serve on committees, on the board of directors, and certainly for sponsorships at our events.
And in terms of why it's important, Ruby, to recognize women for their achievements, why do you think it's valuable to have a Women's Hall of Fame?
The reason why it started is the catalyst was ML Hansen back in the early 80s was asked by her niece to help her with a school project, and that was to write about the accomplishments of women. And she found there were very few resources. And that was the genesis of the Hall of Fame here in Colorado.
Well, certainly on the list here in Colorado, we have a lot of women who can be recognized. Are there other programs that you offer for women in terms of them being able to participate in events?
Yes, we've got a speakers bureau that goes out to all types of organizations. It's composed of our past board members as well as some of our inductees. We also have a portrait exhibit that we can use and an oral history interviews.
All right. Mm-hmm. Where can people go, Ruby, to get more information?
www.cogreatwomen.org.
All right. Great information. Ruby Mayeda, the board chair for Colorado Women's Hall of Fame. Thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you, Beverly.
And thanks for watching Comcast Newsmakers. I'm Beverly Weaver.